this is Foster Projects. It's also known as Martin Luther King Towers. There's decades of basketball history right here in these buildings. And it's close to my current home, so I'll come here the most probably to play because it's a quick bike ride away. And all the kids in here know me. You know, I got fun memories playing against high school kids, and you know, they bugging out that they're like, yo, what are you doing here? I'm like, I live down a block. Because they, you know, people see me on TV, they see me in video games. So for me to be in the projects, it's like for a 12-year-old kid, 16-year-old kid, they're like, you're Bobbito, like we, you know, like it's, you know what I mean? Like, you don't normally see somebody that's internationally famous just show up in a project to play basketball, you know? I did It's the Shoes in 2005 and 2006 on ESPN. And unfortunately, the network didn't decide to keep it alive, you know? But for those two seasons, we took over the world. You know, it was the first TV program in history of media to cover sneaker culture. And, you know, I got to interview Allen Iverson, but also Clark Kent. I got to interview Michael Vick, but also Fat Joe. You know, so it was like a good balance of like athletes that have endorsed deals and also like real sneakerheads that are hip hop, you know, personalities as well. So I thought it was a pretty good show. I was real happy with it. You know, you can go on YouTube, still see episodes, and you know, maybe one day, God willing, inshallah, I'll come back.
I've traveled the world doing basketball performances in Japan, France, no, London, Madrid, Tokyo, Taiwan. I've done shows for NBA, New York Knicks, Hornets, the Mavericks. So it's pretty cool, you know, being in my 40s, still getting paid to have a ball in my hand, you know? It's kind of wild.
I played an N1 mixtape tour in 2006. Yeah, in the fall of 2006 in Puerto Rico, in the new Coliseum there in front of 18,000 people. And it was filmed for broadcast on ESPN, so the whole world, you know, saw me playing basketball in Puerto Rico, representing my island against the N1 mixtape, you know, guys, you know, Mr. 720, Silk, you know, Main Event, like all those guys are so good, you know. That was real special for me. I was actually, you know, in 2006-2007, I was an announcer for the New York Knicks. I was the first Latino broadcaster in their 60-year history, franchise history. And that was great to watch the, you know, basketball is basketball, whether it's in the NBA arena or on the park, it's still the same. You got passes, dribbling. I mean, I prefer the playground because it's, you know, it's more interesting of an environment for me. But nah, I mean, you know, the NBA is wonderful. I love the NBA. I remember back in 2002, I was playing in the Hoops in the Sun tournament in Orchard Beach. And there was a known NBA player that came out there, scored like 7 points. You know, some guys can't play outdoors. They don't know what to do in a freestyle set without a coach. Not everybody's, boom. Joe Hammond had a trial with the Lakers the year that they won the most games in NBA history in a single season. And he beat people in one-on-one, he beat people in shooting games. They offered him a contract, he turned it down. They called him the Destroyer in the playground. You don't get a name like that in Harlem. Unless you really deserve it. The ball's heavy now, it got wet.